crap. That was more than a movie. That was a bloody journey within 3 hours. What up everyone, it's Kirtan Singh here and I'm back with a brand new video. Today I'm doing my initial reaction and thoughts, and my initial review I should say, for Avengers Endgame. I literally just came back from watching the movie. I watched it with my sister, I watched it with my mates Gurjot and Prabh, and holy crap, it was amazing. It is just, I can't describe it that well, but I've got my sister here with me. I'm in her room right now because we're changing things around in my room, so I can't really record in there. So right now I've just set up on her table and everything, so I'm doing that here, and then we'll do the initial thoughts. We'll have no spoilers for the first few minutes, and then after that we'll have a spoiler warning for those that haven't seen the film yet, and we'll talk about some of the things we really liked in the film. Obviously, I didn't take notes this time going into the movie because this is my first time watching it. I'm definitely going to watch it more than once in cinemas, so I will miss a few things which I really liked or which my sister really liked. We'll miss a few things that we want to talk about because there's just so many things going on in our head and we just don't have them all written down in a way that we can really talk about it right now. But nonetheless, there will be spoilers later on in this movie. I'll put a timestamp in. I'll let you guys know when to jump to which section to avoid spoilers. With all that said and done, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, because there's a lot more Avengers content coming soon, and a lot more content in general. Okay, let's get started. Okay, honestly, this movie is amazing. You probably realized from the intro already that I think this movie is more than a movie itself. I think it's a journey. Infinity War and Endgame go together so well, they're basically one movie. And that makes sense, because they were originally called Infinity War Part 1, and then Infinity War Part 2.
Are they going to make her a huge part of it or not?
Yeah, are they going to make Captain Marvel a huge part? Are they going to make, you know, who are they going to put in this forefront? Because Avengers Infinity War was really Iron Man's and Thor's movie. And then who would Captain America obviously be the center of this?
Yeah.
He seemed like it. And then you look at the posters and whatnot. And, you know, you see Iron Man's got a pretty big face in it. He's pretty big main. And the movie does a really good job at balancing all these characters and really giving the limelight to every single one.
Yeah.
And it also hid the limelight from certain characters, which made me really happy. Made my sister also really happy as well, because we were afraid that certain characters would be used too extensively or in a way that wouldn't really suit the story all that well and the characters which we've been following. But we're glad with how these characters were handled. Really happy, yeah. In fact, that some of the character arcs came full circle. And the way the film also played in with previous installments was really well done in ways that I was astounded, to be honest. My favorite character from this movie itself, obviously each overall throughout the whole MCU, we have favorite characters, and mine has always been Iron Man. Since I got into the MCU as a real diehard fan and got into Marvel a lot, obviously I saw a lot of Marvel stuff when I was a kid. But when I got into the comic lore and everything, was around when Avengers came out. The first Avengers. And Iron Man became my favorite superhero. Before then it was really Wolverine. And then also Cyclops. But no, Iron Man became my favorite superhero. And even in this movie, he's still my favorite. My favorite character in this movie itself. And you know, who is your favorite character from this movie?
From this movie, altogether,
really.
I really liked Captain America.
She really liked Captain America, okay.
But then I also really liked Iron Man's, like, story arc and stuff, so...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, so I don't know if you can actually hear her or not, so I'm just gonna hope that she can. Can you say something?
Hello?
Yeah, okay, so her voice is obviously gonna be softer than mine because she's sitting further away. So she said her favorite for this movie is Captain America. Mine was Iron Man. But really, that's what you expect. You know, you expect these two characters, the heart and soul, as the directors put it when they were talking about the characters in Infinity War. They said that Iron Man was the heart and soul of the MCU.
Yeah.
And Captain America, the writers, Stephen McFeely and Christopher Marcus, you know, I give them a round of applause because they really did such a stellar job at connecting everything together. Because you have, they wrote the first Avenger, so Captain America, the first Avenger, they wrote The Winter Soldier, Civil War, Infinity War, and then also Endgame. And then the Russo brothers directed everything out of those except for the first Avenger. And really, you can tell that they always had this goal in mind because of how connected everything feels. And it's something that you don't really see in anything else, you know? Because yeah. Like the only other thing I can personally compare it to would be Star Wars, because how they have all of these movies and books and comics and everything that's tying together, except this does it way better because you can tell there's a set plan, there's a goal, and you can clearly see it. And that's what I love about this movie. I think Infinity War is more rewatchable, but Endgame is more better made, per se, through how it's executed, I guess. Because Infinity War, I say, is fight because, scene to fight scenes.
It's because they lose, because the ending as well.
Because you, for the most part, if you go into this movie, you know how it's going to end. For the most part, you know how it's going to end. With Infinity War, I'm sure some people would say, oh, we knew the snap was coming, we knew this was happening. For the most average person, you didn't see that stuff coming. And it still has that lasting impact on you. So for me personally, Infinity War is more rewatchable, but Endgame I think is slightly better made. This is still my first reaction, so I gotta watch it more times to know for sure. And yeah, so I think that's gonna end it for the spoiler-free part of this initial reaction. So jump ahead to whatever time I put on screen, wherever it is, and then you will be returning to this video portion where there are no spoilers. So in about 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, you've been warned. If you're staying with us for the next few minutes, then you know that you've seen the movie and you're aware that spoilers are ahead. Okay?
Yeah,
ready? Oh my god. I don't know where to begin. Firstly, I will say this. I got the Smart Hulk reveal. I got that spoil. I'm sure a lot of other people did. Like, a lot of people rumored that was going to happen. But the pop vinyls that came out from Zing and EB Games and whatnot, they had on it for the team suits and whatnot, they had Smart Hulk as one of the characters. The moment I read that, I told my sister, don't read the names on the pop vinyls, because this was when I was going to buy one of the pop vinyls. You'll see it in my vlog, which I'm actually working on as well right now. And really, yeah, it spoiled it. And I was like, oh, damn it. Now I know that happens. But my sister,
I didn't know it was going to happen.
She didn't know it was going to happen.
And it was so good, though. I actually really liked it.
Yeah, and it makes so much sense, you know?
Yeah.
Because of the time gap that happens. You kind of knew that, you know, there was going to be some sort of time travel in it. I was kind of hoping not. It's because in Ant-Man and the Wasp, Michelle Pfeiffer's character says, and avoid time vortexes or whatever. And everyone was like, okay, they're going to use time vortexes in Endgame. Yeah. I was kind of hoping that they wouldn't, because I was like, time travel gets so damn complicated.
I just thought that because when they had the spacesuits in the trailer, I thought they were going up to space.
Within realities. Yeah. That one problem, that one of the interviews on Jimmy Fallon actually spoiled that for me, where Captain America Chris Evans was asked one question where it said, what's the most difficult thing or something? I can't remember something. And he's like chafing from wearing the team suits, going into dimensional, you know, portals and whatnot. And then I was like, oh, great. Okay, so now I know that they don't go into space. They go through, like, one of the realities or whatever, the quantum realm and whatnot. You kind of saw that coming as well because of the whole time travel thing. I was kind of hoping they would avoid time travel because I didn't think they'd be able to pull it off. But holy crap, they pulled it off. It was amazing. You know, one of my favorite scenes. I'm trying to go in order of everything that happened, but it's so difficult because there's so many things going into my mind right now, and I want to keep this as short as possible, but I'm going to go through my top favorite 3 scenes of my first viewing, and I'll get my sister to do the same. So my first one is the ending of how Thanos is defeated. The reveal of everyone who's came back to life after the second decimation or the snap. It's not called the decimation, it's probably called the revival or whatever. But the second snap, you know, when everyone comes through the portals by Doctor Strange and Wong and everything. Oh, it was such a good scene. Epic. And then that all led to the final fight with Thanos. And when Tony Stark, Iron Man, gets the Infinity Gauntlet and he says, I am Iron Man. You know, as a person who I said earlier, he's my favorite character. Holy crap. That was an amazing scene. And, you know, I cried when he died. I really did.
Yes,
you know, my sister cried as well. It's just, you know, the MCU, it's just so powerful. For me, it means so much to me on a personal level. And then you know, it's just so well made. It's something you watch and you spend so much time with. You get attached to those characters. You get attached to everything that's going on.
Yeah.
You know, that's my number one favorite scene. What's yours?
Ooh.
Make sure you speak loudly as well, yeah? Because I don't know if they can hear you or not.
I don't know. Okay. Just like off my first...
First view, it's the initial reactions, you know? It can change over time.
Maybe like Captain America getting like Thor's hammer. That was so cool. Captain America
got Thor's hammer. Holy crap.
Like at first I thought it was Thor who was like...
You know, lifting it up lifting and whatnot.
And stuff. And then it went to Captain America. I was like... Because he moved it a little bit
Age of Ultron, he moves it a little bit, and everyone was like, oh, but Captain America is worthy, he's the purest guy. It makes sense, you know, he doesn't have any bad traits. He does, you know, Civil War pointed out how he lies sometimes and how he's like not perfect.
Yeah.
But obviously within the 5-year gap which this film, you know, experiences, Captain America went from, you know, however humble it was with a few negative traits and like lying and whatnot, the imperfect eyes, whatever, to the most humble man you could have possibly had.
Yeah.
And he was able to pick up the hammer. It looked weird though. It looked very odd. It was very odd because
he had like the broken shield. But
it was so amazing. That's probably, I'd say that's probably my, I don't know, to be honest. I don't know where that'd be. That'd be one of my favorite scenes. I don't know where else it would be though. Yeah. So, for me, it's Iron Man's final blow / his death, the lifting of Thor's hammer, Captain America lifting a Mjolnir, and then number three, what would it be? I think it would be Hawkeye / Ronan's character arc. Because they took Hawkeye, who was... I don't think he was the most useless Avenger, because I think he's more useful and powerful than Black Widow. But they took him, and they gave him so much more. Like, Age of Ultron already elevated him to onto the level of, you know, Hulk and Thor at the time. And this movie really made him one of the best Avengers characters, you know, through how... he deals with everything and how he acts. You know, he's not a puny guy with a bow and arrow, you know? He's amazing. So that's probably up there for me. What else did you like? What was your other two favorite?
My other two? It would be that one where, like, Doctor Strange, like, opened all those portals and then everyone came through. It was just, like, such an epic moment.
Because it makes sense. Because one of the predictions I had was that everyone had to come back to life before Thanos was defeated, because especially for characters like Drax, his whole character arc is with defeating and killing Thanos. So that's one thing I wish there was more of. I wish there was a little scene where he was like, you know, I got vengeance for my daughter, for my wife, and whatnot. And, you know, if he came back and it was like, we defeated Thanos already, you know, it's kind of pointless for his character arc, but it worked. You know, that's, it's good that he came in and everything, and the other characters came in. So what was your third?
It's not necessarily a scene, but I just like the start of the movie, where, like, it really shows them down in the dumps, and just, like, losing. And having lost.
Yeah.
I love
Tony's response when he gets rescued, and he's like, the Captain America, I told you all about this, I gave you the warning, I wanted to build a suit, and everything, because he was right. That's the thing. He was right. Everyone else was wrong, and he tried to do everything right, but the way he did it obviously wasn't the best, but his intentions were pure, and people couldn't really see past the idea of his ego and whatnot. So it's really good, because that's what you want to do, you know? When you want to really have this triumphant moment, when you want to set up this finale, you get your characters to the lowest point they're ever going to be. And that's what happened, you know?
Yeah.
It's so evident in how Black Widow cries in that one scene, when she's talking to all the people, you know, Rhodey says, we know where Clint is, you know, what he's doing. And, you know, it's a powerful scene. Like, I wish the actors in this movie could get Oscars for their, you know, performances and whatnot. Like, I get, you know, you get Teen Choice Awards and whatnot.
Yeah.
No one gives a damn about that. You're recognized for it. But it's different. These people, they're putting in, like, roles that, you know, you can't look past. They're giving it their all, and they're playing these characters. And they really should be recognized for this on a wider scale, and not just people saying, you know, yeah, you're good. Chris Evans is Captain America. Robert Downey Jr. is Iron Man. All these characters, actors, are these characters. But, you know, give them some recognition. For God's sake, I swear, you know? Yeah. Black Panther can get a bloody Best Picture nomination, you know? Heath Ledger got the Best Supporting Actor one. You know, so comic book movies can win these. You know, give it to one of these Avengers, for God's sake. I'm so glad that they didn't make Captain Marvel OP. Yeah. You know? Because that's one of the problems. Watching Captain Marvel, the movie itself, the first one, you know, it was mediocre. It wasn't that great. And she was very overpowered. You know, she didn't go through any character development. She was just powerful for the sake of it. And it really made me afraid, made my sister afraid as well, that she would just come in, beat the shit out of Thanos, and, excuse my language, but, you know, she's just gonna beat him down, yeah, and everything.
It's not that you have a problem with her, necessarily, it's just that, like, her character hasn't been built up.
It hasn't been
like
built up.
Like all these other characters, and if she was to come in and beat Thanos, then it just wouldn't have as much of an impact as if, like, any of the other characters did.
And she has, like, 15 minutes of screen time. You know?
Yeah.
Not even. I don't know how much. 15 minutes max. You know, probably 10 minutes for all I care.
Well, then it makes sense because she's in, like,
she's doing all these things with around space and everything. It works. It works with the story.
Yeah.
I kind of don't like how she came in and, you know, was still pretty much really overpowered. But that's because the movie beforehand had already set up her like that. Set her up like that. So there's not much they can do. But really, she Thanos headbutts her and she's not even, like, you know, like, taken back at all. He headbutts her, and she's just like,
but there are other,
you know, scowling at her.
There are other moments, though, that she gets, like, thrown around.
She gets thrown around and stuff. You know, so that's a good thing. It's balanced out enough where, it's balanced out enough where I'm happy with how it was handled, and she wasn't there for a lot of it, which was good. Yeah. I think, yeah, I'm pretty happy with how she was handled. I wonder where it's going to go now. Because the fact that there's like a Black Widow movie happening and there's a Hawkeye TV show, Falcon and everything, you know, Falcon's now the next Captain America, which is good.
I didn't see that coming either.
Yeah, I don't know, because it's good. I thought only Captain America would die, because in Spider-Man Far From Home, I don't know why they showed that trailer before the movie came out, before the movie was played, because it's just ridiculous. Spider-Man's dead. Why are you showing me his trailer before I watch the movie? Mm-hmm. Anyway, regardless, in that one of the trailers, they say, Flash says, oh, Mysterio's like the new Iron Man and Thor put together and whatnot. And then Iron Man's dead. So unless that news isn't public knowledge, it just felt very weird for him to say that, because, like, it was a real, like,
you know. Does that mean that they're both dead?
That they're both,
like Iron Man and Thor.
No, it means that in a sense where it's like, oh, this guy's dead, he's a hero, why would you say that? Especially in front of Peter Parker, who was, like, you know, a surrogate son to Iron Man, and I imagine Peter would react in a really, like,
but, like, he wouldn't know that.
He wouldn't know that, yeah. He wouldn't know that, but if Peter Parker, if this scene actually happens in the movie, and Peter doesn't react in a way where he's, like, you know, remembering Tony Stark, depending on how far away this movie takes place after Endgame, I would be surprised as to why they did it. But I guess that's based on Far From Home, not Endgame. So let's go back to Endgame right now. Tony Stark's funeral was really beautiful. The proof that Tony Stark has a heart.
Yeah.
Really nice. One problem I did have, it's not much of a problem, but more of a thing where I could see, like, that's a bit much, you know? So they have a moment where Captain Marvel is going to get the Infinity Gauntlet to Ant-Man and the Wasp, who were, like, you know, at the Quantum Tunnel. And what happens is Spider-Man's like, how are you going to get through all these people? And in my head, I was like, Captain Marvel could just rocket through them, to be honest. We've seen how powerful she is. She went through a giant ship. You know, she took a headbutt from Thanos. She could just go through the whole, you know, army and get to the quantum tunnel. But the thing is, then they have this moment where, like, one by one or, like, two by threes or whatever, all these women of the superhero women, they come out and they're like, you know, she's not alone or whatever.
Do you know what, though?
It's a powerful moment. I really like it. It looks amazing.
It is a little like, it felt are you doing that? But like,
it felt a little forced. Really cool, though. It's really cool. That's why I don't mind it, because it was really cool, you know. And it wasn't. The one problem I have with it, because in the story itself, Captain Marvel doesn't need help getting there. We've seen how powerful she is. that's the one reason I don't really like it, because it doesn't feel like she needs those people there. Because Infinity War, they had a similar moment where Scarlet Witch was fighting that Proxima, and then Black Widow and Okoye come and help. And in there, it makes sense, because Scarlet Witch was being beaten up, so she needed the help. But here, Captain Marvel, I know she could have just rocketed through. That's the one problem I have. It just felt very forced, because I know Captain Marvel doesn't need the help, and I know, you know, with everything that's going around in society today, women are getting a lot of empowerment. That's not a bad thing, obviously. It's really, like, a real, like, in-your-face kind of moment that's not as well done as it was before, and it feels a very forceful in its message. And, you know, I've got nothing wrong with the message itself, but, you know,
also, I really I'm like not alone. That Scarlet Witch, like, took on Thanos.
Yes.
She's Scarlet Witch to be, like, took on, really took powerful on Thanos. Character.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was and
it's,
really cool.
It's interesting. So Vision isn't going to come back to life.
He's dead.
Loki isn't going to come back to life.
Yeah.
Black Widow isn't going to come back to life. Iron Man, Captain America finally got his dance with Peggy Carter.
Yeah.
Oh, it's cute. So beautiful.
That was cute.
It's perfect.
Yeah.
And then you also have... Who else isn't coming back to life? I guess... Gamora, we're unclear whether or not the new reality Gamora was killed, or whether or not she went with the Guardians, and Thor, who's now a Guardian.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so amazing. Yeah, Thor was just so great.
Fat Thor is so funny.
Yeah. It's a balance between whether or not Fat Thor or Hawkeye is my third favorite moment, actually.
Yeah.
Like, the thing in general, because it's so well done. And... really, okay, I'm going to say the Stan Lee cameo, for his final cameo, rest in peace, Stan Lee, all due respect.
But you don't need to say all due respect.
It wasn't my favorite cameo of his, you know? I was expecting a really lovely cameo or something, but, you know, it really just went past, it was really quick, it was funny,
but sure. Like, that's what it's been like throughout.
That's what it's been like, movies, but so since this is his final cameo, you know,
I
was kind of hoping for one that was really beautiful, or some sort of tribute. But they did all the tribute and everything in Captain Marvel, so that's fine. Yeah. Other than that, I really don't know what else to say. I've been talking for probably 20 minutes by now about this movie. But so I'm going to end the spoiler, unless you have any more spoilers to talk about.
No, I don't think so.
Okay, I'm going to end the spoiler talk there. So hello, everyone. If you've returned to me, or if you probably, I don't know, if you, yeah, you've had to return to me, or you're either continuing on with me, we're not talking about spoilers anymore. We're going to give our final verdict on the film itself. And really, I think this is a really well-made film with how it handles connecting to previous installments in the franchise itself, and how the writers and directors really paved the way towards this film, towards this endgame, was amazing. There probably are faults to the movie. I can't really find them right now in my first viewing.
Yeah, it's cool. We literally just saw it.
It was so awesome, you know. Apart from the few things which I said in the spoilers section of this movie, if you haven't yet seen the film, if you're going to watch the film, when you do watch the film, I should say, make sure you go back and check out my spoiler thoughts on this film itself. You'll know where to go to check that out. So I would give this film probably a 9.2 out of 10, just because I am weary that this is my first viewing. Otherwise, I would bump it up to a 9.5, maybe. Who knows, really, what my final verdict will be. But so far, it's a 9.2 or 9.5 out of 10 from me.
Because
it's such a stellar movie. How about you, Banner?
I'd probably go 9 out of 10.
My sister gives it a 9 out of 10. So basically, we're in the 9 out of 10. What is that? A+. A+ for Avengers Endgame. Okay. Go watch the movie. It's amazing. I'm gonna watch it more than once. I'll probably watch it, you know, I don't know if I'm gonna watch it with my whole family, I'm gonna watch it with more friends, or maybe the same friends, who knows. Nonetheless, if you've enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to my channel for more videos every week, or whenever I upload them, to be honest, because right now I've actually been churning out a lot of videos, and I actually have my placement coming up, so I'm not sure if I'll do a lot of videos in the coming weeks. Nonetheless, if you want more Endgame talk, more talk in general, I'm a nerd, I'm a moviegoer, I'm a TV show liker, I really don't know what that means, but you know what, just subscribe to my channel, leave a comment down below on what you thought about Endgame, when are you going to see it, who knows, just make sure you don't put any spoilers in there whatsoever, and I'll catch y'all next time. See ya.